Hello, I'm going to show you how to make soaked and sprouted seed for feeding finches. This is done because the sprouted seed is very nutritious, much more so than ordinary dry seed. Now, I've tried quite a few methods, most of which have failed for me, so I'm going to show you the one that I've just recently found that for me works really well. I'm very happy with it. So things I have tried are the soaking method. When you get a little dish like this, make holes in it, put the seed in there, put that in a non-perforated dish, soak it for a while, drain it, leave it that way, periodically rinse it, that kind of thing. Now that, using just plain tap water, didn't go well for me, so I tried something else that was recommended, which is virkon-s. It's a veterinary disinfectant that's really a very good product, but still I didn't like the idea of using that and having so much of it left on the seed, and it just, even that didn't really go well for me. I didn't get such good sprouting. So then I tried, or in fact earlier I tried, a simple product, a water cleanser, very common product. Many of them have this formula, so it's just chlorhexidine digluconate, which is a water cleanser, which I wasn't using for anything else. I don't actually put it in their water, so I tried that, but no joy. So what was happening was, even though I was using the water cleanser, the seed would end up smelling a bit musty or developing mold, which you don't want, because that's incredibly dangerous for finches, very, very unhealthy, whereas clean, fresh, sprouted seed is extremely healthy. So, the latest I've hit upon is this wonderful thing. A tea strainer. This is a big tea strainer, so it's designed for herbal teas, for example, which is why it's so large. So, seed goes in here. Do this carefully with one hand. You can do that. Sort of near the rim, like that. Now, the seed I happen to be using here is a product called Golden Cob, which is an Australian brand that I rather like. It always seems to be fresh and clean. It is a mixed seed, so these will sprout at different rates, which isn't ideal. If you can get just plain millet or a mix of millets that are likely to sprout at the same time, that's slightly better, but this is still good. So, lid goes on the top. I'm just going to do that with two hands for 1 minute. There we go. Lid on in there. So, over to the sink. Now, I just use plain tap water. Now, in Sydney, where I live, the tap water is clean. It's got all kinds of, you know, lovely disinfectant chemicals in it, like chloramine and so on, but that's actually quite good for this purpose. So I give it a very, very good rinse, a vigorous rinse to wash off any spores or bits and pieces that might be on there. So sorry about the noise, I just want to demonstrate how vigorously I rinse it. Rinsed seed. Now, the little tea strainer has a convenient little hook, and I happen to have a convenient little spot to hang it, so that just hangs there in the sink. So I'm in the laundry actually, and I walk by here several times a day, rinse that again in the same way twice a day, so morning and evening, or sometimes I'll do it even three or four times if I happen to be walking by. What I find is doing that, so no chemicals, nothing, just, well, except what's in Sydney tap water, produces fresh, clean seed. And that, it doesn't look like much, that little container, but I find for 30 birds or so, that actually is a really nice little everyday supplement. So if you have more, you may need something bigger. You may well be able to find a similar container as this, that's larger, but this is the one I have. It's good for 30 birds. So we'll leave that there for 24 hours in the summer is enough to give some sprouting results. In cooler weather, you may need at least 36 hours, and sometimes I like to leave it for 36 just to get it really nice and sprouted. So we'll come back and look at that tomorrow. Okay, one day has gone by. Now we've had some really warm weather in the last 24 hours, so I'm hoping we'll have some sprouted seed here. So we're going to harvest it, starting with a final rinse. So I'm going to give it another vigorous rinse, so prepare yourself for the noise for a moment. Off the lid like that. So we have it. A little bit of a jiggle, drain the water. Now that's very wet, so we'll just sit it on the towel here for a few minutes just to drain and to soak some of the water, because you don't want to serve it absolutely sopping wet, but just moist. So we'll come back to that in a moment. There we go, some freshly sprouted seed. I've taken the lid off and blotted it on the towel here, and you can see it's filled up a bit more because there's a bit of swelling of the seed and sprouting that's gone on. So you don't want to absolutely pack the container, you want to fill it just sort of relatively full. And this goes in here like that, little feed dish. There we go. Probably can't see, the sprouts are so tiny at this stage of sprouting, you probably can't see it on the video. But that's how I feed it, in a little dish like that, in a hanging platform feeder in the aviary. Something you may like to do as well, you can also mix protein powders or something else, other supplements, in through the seed in a small quantity. That can be quite a good way to feed supplements. But this in and of itself is a good supplement. And this smells nice and fresh and clean and not musty. So there you go.